Becca, and welcome to a meaningful day of Easter and spring decorating in our home here at the Carriage House. The past few weeks I've been busy getting our home ready for spring, and up until now I've been using lots of spring decor such as mossy eggs, little bunnies, pastel tea cloths, which is wonderful, but today I wanted to add a little bit more meaning as I decorate our living room. So I'm really glad you're here with me and looking forward to another day of spring decorating. Now, the past few weeks I've been having tea while decorating, but today it's really late on Saturday afternoon and my husband is getting ready to make dinner here soon since he cooks on Saturdays. So I decided to enjoy a glass of red wine while I decorate, and I'm going to be actually using the red wine to decorate here a little bit later. And I know you probably can't help but noticing my lovely black eye here. I know it's horrific looking. Our one-year-old son slugged me again right in the eye, but instead of using his head, he decided to use his wooden play toaster this time. But right now I have some really pretty silk white lilies that I'm going to place around in the living room. Some say Easter lilies grew where Jesus' tears and blood fell from the cross, and lilies were supposedly found in the Garden of Gethsemane after the crucifixion. So from dull-looking bulbs that are underground for years, they eventually sprout to life and they become beautiful flowers, reminding us of Jesus' brutal death and holy resurrection. But lilies just overall represent rebirth and hope and life, and I would love to bring living ones inside our home, but since we have a lot of cats, it's probably not a good idea. So just gonna finish putting these around the living room. So now that the Easter lilies are put out, we're going to make candles and eggshells, which is really fun and relaxing, and this is a wonderful family tradition to make and have this time of year. So after the candles are done, we're going to place them on those three ceramic egg cup holders that I just put on that little white stand on our table in the living room, and Easter morning we'll light the candles. So while the wax melted in a double broiler, I went ahead and got our eggs, and all I did was I used a serrated knife and I gently tapped on the top half of the egg until the shell broke, and then I poured out the entire egg, and then I did this whole process again for two more eggs. So it's really simple, and afterwards I should have a nice jagged edge left on the eggshell from the serrated knife. After I rinsed and dried the eggshells, I placed them into these eggshell holders I was telling you about, and then my kids and I are going to place candle wicks into the eggshells, and then I'll carefully pour the wax into the shells. So very quickly, before the wax cooled and hardened, we looked through our box of dried flowers, and I knew to instantly search for the red rose petals, and I spoke gently to my children about how the rose symbolizes Jesus' death and how the five petals of the rose represent the five wounds that Jesus endured before and after his crucifixion. And the color of red represents the blood that he shed. So we lightly sprinkled red rose petals in the wax, and then we let the wax harden. And also too, the reason I chose three eggs is because of the Holy Trinity. So the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. To use dried moss to decorate with, and going to add it to a jar, and I'm going to put little fairy lights in the jar as well. And I always like to decorate with moss at Easter time, because if you think about it, moss doesn't have roots in order to thrive on this earth, so moss can help us remember to not be deeply rooted into the earth and the world, because someday we will be transplanted into a beautiful heavenly garden. Thank you. on that same table where the egg candles are, I'm going to add a little bowl of bread and a small vessel of red wine just to remind us of the meal he shared with his disciples on the night before he died. Then after that, I'm going to add just a few more spring type of decor in the living room.
Thank you.